So as you learned at Shark Bay, microbes are much more important in the environment than you might have thought about before. And that turns out to be true through all of Earth history. In fact, if you get to before about 500 million years ago, about 500 million years ago, what we find in the fossil record is that there's no more bones, no dinosaur bones or trilobites or anything like that, no petrified wood, no fossilized plants. When we get before about 500 million years ago, what we find predominantly are fossilized forms of microbes, fossilized forms of things kind of like what you see at Shark Bay. That's the case here at North Pole in Western Australia, very famous locality because the rocks here are about 3.5 billion years old, and they hold the oldest, essentially uncontested evidence of life on Earth. That kind of evidence is our structures like this here, this domical feature here, which to the geologist are very reminiscent of the sort of domical structures we see in the modern stromatolites in Shark Bay. And if you look around more carefully, if you have a trained eye, what you find here are all sorts of very fine features, crinkly laminations that really look like fossilized forms of microbial mats. This is not just the domical structure, it's also the details of the laminations that we find inside those sort of structures around here, all of which add up to, we believe, evidence of biology of microbes, very much like the Shark Bay cyanobacteria living 3.5 billion years ago. That's the dominant form of life that we find. The dominant evidence of life, in fact, it's the only evidence of life just about, aside from some contentious microfossils, that we find in rocks of this antiquity and through most of Earth history. Now, this is hard to recognize, right? To the untrained eye, this is a lump of rock. And to the untrained eye, if you look around here in general, this is not a spectacular locality from an aesthetic standpoint. But it takes a lot of training to recognize that there are fossil structures here. And even for trained experts, we argue quite a lot about the interpretation of these things. We can tell that there were microbes living here, but we aren't really sure what they were doing. We argue a lot about whether they were doing exactly what the Shark Bay microbes are doing, which is to say, making oxygen. That would be very exciting if they were. It's also exciting if they weren't, if we could figure out what they were doing. So in order to try to figure that out, to figure out what the life was actually doing in the past, we need to look for other signs of evidence. We need to look for evidence of the impact of the metabolisms of these organisms on the environment. For example, if we want to test the hypothesis that these microbes were making oxygen, we might want to look in the environment, in these rocks or in related rocks that are of similar age or younger, for evidence of the impact of oxygen produced by such microbes on the environment. That would be a supporting line of evidence. So those are the kind of things we turn to. We turn from thinking about shapes and structures to thinking about metabolisms and the consequence of metabolisms for the environment.